looked on YouTube to find a video on how to install the spring spacer, and everyone I've saw says remove the spring, undoing a bunch of stuff, track bar, this, that, blah, 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 blah. I'm lazy, I want to do it as little as possible, so I thought, why not use one of these? It's a spring compressor that I use to change these coil springs on struts. So I'm going to attempt to do this. I couldn't find a video that said do it, don't do it. So I'm going to attempt it. If it works, that's great. We'll pass the knowledge on. If it doesn't, you have an entertaining video of me getting a spring in my face. And so this is what I'm going to do. First step is, of course, jack the vehicle up, put it on jack stands, take the tire off. If you don't know that much, then you shouldn't be attempting to remove a spring. And if you feel it's unsafe, or if you feel it's outside your well, get a mechanic to do it. There's no shame in hiring somebody to do your dirty work for you. And so with all to do, let's take the spring off.
One of the first things you'll need is PB Blaster. And the second thing we're going to need is the big honking soda. Can't do anything without a little refreshment. And also, a milk crate to sit on. Next, I want to jack up the axle and compress the spring. Next, I want to install my spring compressor. Make sure you use all the safety clips for it. Next, I want to remove the spring retaining clip. And then I'm going to remove the shocks. Next, I'm going to remove my sway bar link. Next, I grabbed a big pair of channel locks and just pulled my bump stop out. It's just it just snaps right in and pops right out. Then I'm going to lower the axle. And slicker than it's not, the spring should just pop out.
Look at that, slicker than it's not. Okay, now I'm going to go set this far away from me.
Before I put it all back together, I cleaned the whole wheel well. And I'm just going to hit it with some black paint just to dress it up and make it look sharp.
And now's the perfect time for me to get a nice lazy snack. Lazy, I'm meaning somebody else making it for me. I'll let you know how that works out. Well, the good news is I was able to get a snack. Bad news was I had to obtain it myself. Bagel and cream cheese, pretty good. It'll hold me over. Now let's get back to work.
While I had the tire off and had easy access, I just went ahead and greased everything.
Let's see if these will stay out.
And I slid my coil spring spacer in the original spring seat back over the bump stop.
That seat's pretty good. I feel it's going to rub off all the paint I put on. There. No fuss, no muss. I should be in the shop more. No fuss, no muss.
Assembly just in reverse. Install the spring.
Okay.
Install the spring retaining clip. I put anti-seize on everything to make it easier to take apart. Raise the axle. Remove the spring compressors. And pop the bump stop back in place. Use a little anti-seize on it to lubricate it and snap right in. Your teeth are not a tool. Then I installed my sway bar link and put my shock back on. And here's about where my recorder died.